anybody here who plays a musical instrument at Clifftop? Okay, almost everybody. And so flatfooting to me is like where this dancing came from, and it evolved eventually into clogging. Clogging is a more stylized version of it. But it's harder, I think, for people to share flatfooting because it's such an individual expression of the dance and the rhythms as you're hearing them. So there's all these different components. And so if you come to this workshop every day and hear all the different dancers, hopefully everybody will give you something to take away to help you add to your repertoire of sounds that you can make with your feet. Because as a flatfoot dancer or a clogger, you are the drummer to traditional music. The floor is your drums, your feet are your drumsticks. And every time you put your foot down on the floor, you want to make sure it's in time with the music. That's the most critical thing. So simple is better until you get control of what you're doing. And so you've already seen some pretty advanced stuff, all right? And so I come from this tradition of, I grew up like going to dances and seeing people do buck dancing and flat footing, not really even realizing that's what it was in eastern North Carolina. And then I got involved with the Greengrass Cloggers 46 years ago. And for years, the Greengrass Cloggers just did this one basic step. And we were the young hippie team from eastern North Carolina, away from the traditions of the clogging teams in the mountains. And we went to folk festivals in Philadelphia and Washington, D.C., and Canada, Michigan, and everywhere we went when we danced, these little dance teams sprung out in that tradition, up out of that tradition. And so I would like to actually take you back to something that you will be able to take home with you. So people will see somebody like Doc Watson play the guitar, or used to see him play the guitar, and want to be able to flat pick like Doc Watson. They think they can just jump out there and do that. But it helps if you know how to make chords first. So trying to learn the flat foot without knowing what's happening with the foundation of these rhythms and how it fits into the phrasing of the music, it's like jumping way ahead, and it leaves a lot of people behind. So I'm going to teach you like a really simple version. It's going to all play back into your flat footing. But to begin with, I bet it's going to have something so like a little pattern. And so just to begin with, just make your right toe and leg as long and straight as you can. This is like a little stretch. Pull your toe back up. Most of us don't think about communicating with our feet. Push your toe back out, point it back up to the ceiling, and then shake your ankle and your knee loose. And most of your motions from flat footing and clogging will be coming from your ankle being nice and limber. Point your left toe up, point it back out straight, point it up, point it back out, and shake it loose. And so now see if you can make your right toe draw a circle. Point it up to the ceiling, to the right, down, up, and around. Keeping your heel close to the floor, rotating your toe in a circle to the right. Now circle back to the left. You'll feel like you're square dancing here in a minute. Check your ankle and your knee loose. Both feet back down in your usual position. Your left toe up, over, down, and up. Keeping your heel close down, and then back around. And shake your ankle and your knee loose. All right, so this little rhythm of eight with me. So in clogging, it's in four, all those old time tunes are in 4/4 time. You can do things in multiples of 4/8. If you guys will play us a little tune, I'm going to ask you to do this little pattern with me just a couple times to make sure you're listening to the phrasing of the music. These old time tunes usually have an A part and a B part, like a verse and a chorus to a song. And we'll get cats in the butter to play us a fiddle tune. This is not my space. I'm going to do the kind of the old version of learning, the monkey see, monkey do method that Willard Watson would talk about. So we're going to clap our hands together 8 times to the music, and we're going to be bending our knees and bouncing in between. Touch your right toe out on the floor 7 times on the count of 8, and you'll come back down and bend your knees 8 times. You do your left toe, your right toe and back, bouncing between left toe and back. Raise up on your toes and drop your heels 8 times. Bounce in between, right back on your heels and drop your toes 8 times, just to get you all in sync with music. All right, let's have a tune from over here. Listen to this tune, not that one. So your count would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. Clap 8 times. And bounce. Bounce, just bend your knees. Be relaxed. 5, 6, put your right toe out. 8, and bounce. Leave your legs straight. Let your toe go up and down. 7 times. And 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Bounce. 5, 6, and your right toe and back. And 1, 2. Sit down on 8. Bounce. 5, 6, and your left toe and back. legs up on your toes and drop your heels. And bounce. Right back on your heels and drop your toes. All right, now just without thinking too much, I want you just to walk in place, lifting your knees up, stepping on the beat of the music, and wait to the top of the phrase and start with your right foot, 5, 6, and step on the beat, and step, step, step this 8 times. Now bounce 8 times, and bounce, 5, 6, and step on the beat, and step, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and bounce. 5, 6, and step on the beat, and step. And every time you put your foot down, see if you can lift your weight up and pull back. Just try it. Don't think too much. Everybody go back and bounce. Bounce. And step on the beat. Step, 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 step. Pull back. And go back and bounce. 5, 6, and step on the beat. All right. Good job. Now, so I'm going to go back and show you just like steps that I can teach you in about 10 minutes. It's a basic step that's used by the greengrass cloggers and every team that started from the greengrass cloggers. There have been over 200 of them over the last 47 years that have used this as their foundation to do precision clogging. And this is not what this workshop is about. This workshop is about flat footing, but I still think it's like this is getting your fingers on those guitar strings and make your G chord and that C chord so and the F chord is so hard to make. So what I want you to do is you're going to be going back again instead of up and down. It's what we were just doing on that two sound version of the walking steps, what you did at the end. But now we're going to be bending your knees again, going down and up. You're going to take your right foot and you're just going to go point step, point step, point step, point step, point step, point step, point step. Just shifting your weight. Point step, point step, point step. And stop. This time you're gonna go point, step, 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 point, step, 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 point, step, 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 point, step, step, step. This little pattern will fit exactly into the phrase of the music. And then you can start to do rhythm changes within this pattern to accent parts of the tune as you're hearing them. But this is your foundation for the greengrass clogger basic step. And this wasn't just the greengrass cloggers, there were other clogging teams in the 70s and 60s that were using a version of this same step. Don't speed up. Point, step, 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 point, step, step, step. Now, some people will differ on whether or not shuffles are even used in flat footing. And that just depends on your individual preference. But in this basic step, where you're making no sound, the reason it doesn't sound very much what a lot of people think clogging sounds like is there's a space in there where you're making no sound, and suddenly you're going to put a two-sound shuffle, two beats really quick together. And so where you're kicking your foot out and making no sound, it suddenly sounds like this. Shuffle, step, 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 shuffle, step, 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 shuffle, step, step, step. Hardest thing for people to learn, don't let it hang you up because it's not essential in order for your flat footing, but it's a good way to fit in all those spaces. You can make the shuffle two ways. You can make it with the ball and toe of your foot, which is the same shuffle used in Irish and French Canadian and English step dancing. It's used in most forms of American step dancing. Or you can make it with your heel and toe if you prefer. You can make a heel toe shuffle, heel toe step, 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 heel toe step. But if you go ahead and learn this as a ball toe shuffle, flicking your foot out and pulling it back, shuffle, step, step, step. Now, immediately I've seen people think that you've got time to touch your toe and go touch, touch, and then pick it up and put it down to make your shuffle. You don't have that a chance because you're already shifting your weight to the other side as you're making that second sound. So just try this with me. I'm speeding up something I would normally teach in like a week-long class in about 20 minutes here, okay? Y'all are doing great. Everybody's just doing amazing. So take your foot this time. Your knee's going to be your hinge. Your ankle's completely loose and relaxed. Your toes just dangling down. And let your knee keep your feet out in front of you. Unless I specifically ask you to bring your foot back here, for most flat-footing, it's going to be right out in front of you or right underneath you. So let your foot just swing back and forth with your toe going down until you go and start to strike the floor as you go down lower. Out, back, but keep it out in front. Don't bring it back here. Out, back, and your knees kind of going down, up, your toes kind of striking the floor. Try it with your left foot. If you're right-handed, your left foot's not going to need as well for you. Out, back, keep it up front. Your weight on the other side. This time your foot is going to strike the floor on the way out, and when you come back, you're already putting your foot down. So you're going to go out, back, step, shuffle, drop, out, back, step. When I say step, I'm talking about changing your weight and putting your foot down flat. Shuffle, step. Back and do that little pattern where we were doing point, step, and then we'll put the shuffle in there, and you will have the green grass clogger basic step as your best friend for all your other foundations of dancing as you learn flat footing here in the next few days. This will be your go-to. You can do this when you're waiting in line and you're playing music in the grocery stores. You'll find a tune. You can dance to any music in four times. Here's how we'll get started. We're going to bend our knees on the number. We'll go and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8. And on the next hand, after I say 8, is when you point your toe out to get the pattern started. And then you can, at your own, you know, whenever it feels right to you, stick those shuffles in there and start filling up the sound. So let's do the count together. And 5 and 6 and 7 and kick. Point, step, step.